Gonna share some of my favorite hair care and maintenance products that I use every time I wash my hair or I try to manage my color treated hair. And I have very fine thin hair, and I've been doing balayage for about 3-4 years, I would say, and this is probably the second lightest I've been, because I was actually around this time of last year even lighter, but all over blonde. So I am kind of recovering, and I did get a trim the last time I got my hair done in July, but I do want to maintain this long length. So if you want to see what products I use, keep on watching. Okay, so as for the first one, I use the Olaplex number 4, the Bond Maintenance Shampoo. It states that it repairs, strengthens, and hydrates all hair types. And as for this, I believe it's free of sulfates. And the one thing that I do really realize with this is that it lathers like crazy for being a sulfate-free shampoo. So a little goes a long way with this. So as you can see, I am almost done. I need to get another one. I really like it because the smell's really nice, it lathers very well, and it's sulfate-free, so it's good for color-treated hair. But other than that, I couldn't like tell you, oh, the texture of my hair changed that much, but so far I really like it, and I'll probably get another one. I'll get into the conditioner of the same line later. For purple shampoo, I use Fenola, and I have this huge bottle because my hair is always light, and I hate when my hair turns brassy. So my hairstylist recommended for me to only use this once a week because it does really dry out your hair because it's toning the color. And what she recommended was to actually mix in this in 1-to-1 ratio and like a deep conditioner. She has a hair mask and leave it on for 30 minutes to an hour. I don't think it's really necessary to leave it longer than that. And when you do that and then you can rinse it out, it will tone into a very nice cool tone, depending on where your hair color stage is at, to be honest, because if it's in that in-between stage where it's like, it hasn't lifted enough from the bleach and like from what your stylist did, it's not gonna really have that much of an effect. You have to kind of start with a foundation of a little more cool toned hair. So I really like that one because it gets rid of all the orange and the brassiness and the yellowness. It does dry my hair, and that's why it's a little dry right now. But I do bounce back from different ones because I feel like my hair gets used to shampoos pretty often. And honestly, that's like with everything, skincare and hair. I think it's good to rotate the products you use so your body doesn't get used to it. So like other times that I would wash my hair without the Olaplex, I typically use Joico. It's the Defy Damage line, and that one's also very good for color treated hair as well. Conditioners. The one that follows the shampoo that I use is the Olaplex number 5, and this is the Bond Maintenance Conditioner. Same thing, it says it repairs, strengthens, and hydrates all hair types. And by the way, these ones are both bigger size, I believe, 250 milliliters or 8.5 fluid ounces. Honestly, I go through the shampoo a lot faster just because I am using a lot of hair treatments all the time, so I'm not using the conditioner as often. Plus, I don't wash my hair as frequently as maybe another person does. But if I do find that my hair is pretty hydrated, then I will just use this when I wash my hair. I really like it. It's pretty nourishing for your hair. So, but when I want a deeper conditioning, I use the number 3, the Olaplex Hair Perfector. And this is a bit smaller. I can show you. It's like a more of a concentrated hair treatment. And so this one is 100 milliliters, 3.3 fluid ounces. They recommend to use once per week, and then for damaged hair, use it 2-3 times per week. Typically, I will use a spray bottle, a water spray bottle, and drench my hair, and then put this on, leave it on for about 20-30 minutes, and then you have to wash it out and go on with your regular shampoo and conditioner routine. And this really does moisturize the hair. I think I'll have to use this week. Okay, moving on. So as for hair masks, I've been alternating between two. These are probably like my favorite ones that I've tried so far. Mind you, a lot of these products are a little more on the pricier side, but I really do find that they really last me a long time, and they're really worth the investment. And especially for me, I want to keep my length, so it's important to keep your hair healthy. I use the Moroccan Oil Intense Hydrating Mask, and this one is for medium to thick dry hair. I actually have very thin, fine hair, but I don't use like too much of this, and if I do use it, I only leave it on for about a minute or two in the shower while I'm rinsing my body and everything like that. And this is very, very hydrating. This is the hydration line. So when I'm not using this, because I do find that my hair gets used to these, I'm using the It's a 10 Miracle Hair Mask. And this one is the bigger size as well. This is the 17.5 fluid ounces. Claims that it detangles, restores moisture balance, instantly restores elasticity, softens, smooths, imparts luminous shine, enhances natural body, nourishes, defrizzes, and improves color vibrancy. Honestly, because I am only washing my hair twice a week, I alternate between these two and use it as my conditioner instead of a regular conditioner like the Olaplex, just because my hair is so damaged, or one of the two times I wash my hair in the week, I'm using Fanola, so it dries my hair a lot. As for coming out of the shower, I use It's a 10 Miracle Leave-In product interchangeably with this one, which is the Healthy Sexy Hair Tri-Wheat Leave-In Conditioner. This one claims that it detangles, and I feel like they do a little, both of them, but not like anything that I notice like crazy. This one is 8.5 fluid ounces, and this is 10 fluid ounces. So this one's a little bigger actually. And then I use this with a comb to brush out my hair. And then as for care products or styling products, I also do use the Moroccan oil treatment, and this is for all hair types. This is very popular for a reason, because I don't know, I'm not like a huge fan of the smell, something that I had to get used to because it is a very potent smell, but it is a very concentrated oil that helps the end of my hair. So I need a trim soon, but it just detangles it all and gives it a lot more sheen and silkiness. So as for blow drying my hair, I use the Kenra Platinum Blow Dry Spray, and this is an advanced dry thermal protected. What I love about this is when you blow dry your hair, it dries so much faster. It cuts down like half the time, and it makes your hair very smooth and silky after. So I notice when I don't use this, it's not the same. It does claim that it reduces the blow dry time up to 50%, and it provides an intense thermal defense up to 428 degrees Fahrenheit, and resist humidity for up to 20 hours. And it's very lightweight. My hair doesn't get oily off of this, and I just spray it like all randomly throughout my hair like this, and then I just blow dry it. It looks so nice after, so I really highly recommend this. As for everyday things, like weird to me because I never understood why or like how Batiste worked on people's hair. I never found that my hair would soak up any oils with this product. So I was using Living Proof for so long, their dry shampoo. I love that product, but I ran through it so fast. Less than a month, it'd be done. That was like about, I would say, 20 some dollars. Whereas this one is only like $7. At CVS, there's always a buy one, get one free. So I've just gotten accustomed to this. It does the job. I mean, I do find that I like the original Clean and Classic scent the best, because I tried the like Shine one or something, but it made my hair look so greasy. Smell doesn't bother me too much. It's a little strong when you first do it, but you have to like shake it and make sure you spray it evenly throughout the hair so it doesn't leave that white powder. And yeah, I just use that all throughout my roots on days I just don't have freshly washed hair. And the last product that I swear by is the Paul Mitchell Invisible Wear Volume Whip. It does say humidity resistance and natural hold. It's basically the whipped mousse, so you're just supposed to shake it and then apply it to damp hair. So what I use this for is when I curl my hair, because I have very thin, fine hair, and you would think it would hold a curl, especially because it's color treated and a little damaged. My hair literally never holds a curl. I could use it on my damp hair, good like 1 to 2 pumps all over the bottom, blow dry it out, and I will curl it once it's fully dry. This thing is so great because it doesn't give you that crunch feel while also literally holding my curls all day. Your hair feels actually softer using this, so it looks so nice. No matter what I've tried, like clips, letting it cool, all these different hairsprays, nothing worked for me, and this really worked. So if you're having trouble keeping your hair curls to stay in, I really, really recommend this. This one is 6.8 fluid ounces or 200 milliliters. It's like a pump applicator. So that's all my hair care products that I've been using. Honestly, I've learned a lot, I feel like, through my hair journey, because in the beginning I didn't really feel the need to invest in products. Like, I didn't really take care of my hair. I was washing my hair every single day, but now training my hair to only wash it twice a week and using all these products that are nourishing to my hair, it really does make a difference. So I do recommend these products, and I will list all the links below. I'll add the prices below as well. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you guys want to see more of these type of videos. I'll probably try to do like a favorite skincare stuff because I'm testing a lot of skincare products right now. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and let me know if you guys get any of these products and how you like them. Bye. I'm not going to do that.